When I first started coaching about 10 years ago, I started working with a runner who was sedentary, she was a lifelong smoker, and had been running for about 2 months when we first started working together. And it was hard to coach her because we really couldn't do very many workouts, because every workout that she ran, no matter if it was an easy run, a faster training session, or really anything in between, her heart rate was really, really high. Now, this wasn't a phenomenon that I had experienced either personally in my own running with any of my teammates during cross-country indoor track when I was at the high school or collegiate level, and none of the coaches that I had over the years. And I think I had more than 10 coaches since I started running back in the late 90s. They never talked about this. We never experienced it. We never addressed it. So this was something that I had to learn more about. And it ended up being that this is something that is basically a very poorly developed aerobic system. Some coaches might call it aerobic deficiency syndrome. It can happen when you either don't really have any experience with aerobic or endurance-oriented exercise, and any amount of that exercise is going to cause your heart rate to really skyrocket. Now, it can also happen if you underdevelop the aerobic system while overdeveloping the anaerobic system. So for a lot of power athletes who do virtually no aerobic exercise whatsoever, but who might do a lot of VO2 max work, who might do a lot of high intensity interval training or maximum effort lifting or sprinting, then this is a common phenomenon. So once we recognize that this issue is because of too much anaerobic work, too much high intensity training, and not enough low intensity training, then we have the solution in front of us. The solution, if you are experiencing a high heart rate all the time, maybe you've just started running, maybe you've been doing other sports, maybe you've just taken a really long time away from running and you're getting back into it. If that's the case, and you're finding that even on a short, relatively easy run, which should be super easy, your heart rate is just really high, then the fix for this kind of a problem is a very high volume of very easy running. Now, some of that running might actually have to include walking. If you find that your heart rate is still up really high, if you are just trying to run as slow as you can, then this is going to be a really good opportunity for walking breaks. Now, this might also be a great opportunity for using something like the Maffetone method, where you calculate a certain aerobic heart rate and you're never allowed to run at a heart rate higher than that. So there's a couple different ways of addressing this aerobic deficiency syndrome, or otherwise an underdeveloped aerobic system. It just requires a lot, high volume of very easy exercise. Sometimes that might include running. Wait. Let's correct that. Sometimes that might include walking. And even though we're runners and we don't want to walk, we really want to run, especially if you're someone who used to be in much better shape and you're finding that you do now have to use some walk breaks to keep your heart rate under control, then that's okay. And the hardest part of this type of training strategy is the fact that you're going to have to take two steps backward in order to start taking steps forward. So while your ego might not be happy with you, while you know you might have your self-esteem be knocked a little bit by training so much slower than you used to or having to use walking breaks, this is the only way to dig yourself out of this hole. You have to run a lot of miles at a very easy pace. Okay, a couple caveats, because sometimes the advice I just gave you is not going to work. Sometimes your heart rate might be high, not because you have an underdeveloped aerobic system, but because you are overtrained. Now, for most runners, it's really hard to become overtrained. You need an extraordinarily high amount of high intensity exercise and not enough recovery. Most athletes simply aren't training hard enough to become overtrained, because overtraining syndrome really is a physiological process that's occurring inside your body. It's not simply that you're tired or that you're not improving, it's that your body is not responding to exercise. All that training you're doing, it's just too much stress for your body. So it's essentially shutting down and you are not adapting to it, you're not recovering from it. The exercise byproducts, the hormones that are in your blood when you exercise, you know, they indicate a high level of stress. And so this is not something that we can simply train through. We can't ignore it. We need to take some time away from exercise and allow our bodies to get back to neutral. Now, the other caveat with training very, very slow or using walking breaks to keep your heart rate under control is that this is a long-term process. It's not something that's going to be resolved in a week or two. It might take 1, 2, or 3 months. So it does take time, be patient, and it is a little boring because you're not doing normal training. You're not doing the workouts. Maybe you're not doing long runs, but you're really just working at a very low intensity for a relatively high volume. And so because it is boring, because it is a knock to your ego, it's one of those things where you're probably going to feel like you are being tempted to run faster. I want you to hopefully stay strong, stay consistent with what you need to do, which is really just a lot of easy running. So if you do find yourself in this kind of a situation where your heart rate is really high all the time, this can be somewhat common in beginner runners who start running as adults who don't have this long history with exercise or participating in other sports. So if that's you, then just know that you have a little bit of work to do. All you need to do is keep the effort of your runs very easy. Make sure that your heart rate is staying at a reasonable level. You probably don't want to go much higher than 60 to 70% of your max. And over time, you will progress. That very easy pace at a low heart rate will ultimately get faster and faster. And once you've built up that a much bigger aerobic base, then you'll actually have something to sharpen with those more race-specific workouts, with that speed work. But if you don't have that base, then you don't really have anything to sharpen. So be really consistent with the easy running. Walk if you have to, and you're gonna get there.